Now, Enology, blindfolds on, please.
What? Ring a ding ding.
Here we go. Everybody got blindfolds
on? Hold
on.
Yes.
So, we're going to place something in front of you. It's nothing dangerous at all. It's actually rather pleasant.
Is it a kitten?
It is even nicer than a kitten. So, just we're just going to put your hands up. Oh, there we go.
Thank you.
Right. So, we're going to do one at a time, please. So, Bill, I would like you to taste what you have in front of you and tell me what it is.
OK. All right, then. OK.
What do you think that is?
Oh, it's a wine.
Yes, some what kind of wine?
A red or white?
Yes, please.
Oh, red.
You're going to go red, are you? OK, Phil. Phil, have a glass, have a sip. It's right in front of you.
Darling. I'm looking for the cheese.
OK, all right.
What have you got? Red or white?
It's a red.
Red, OK. And Claudia, what do you reckon it is?
We've had white and red. What else could it be?
Is it, give me your rosé.
Yes.
Rosé. Alan, what do you reckon yours is?
Disgusting.
It's a low budget. What do you reckon it is? Don't look, don't look.
Red.
Red, you're going to go red. It is to do with our inability, actually, mostly, to taste what it is. So, Bill, yours is a room temperature white, so most people would think it was red because it was
too confusing. Yeah.
Phil, you had a chilled red.
A chilled red.
So, that is sometimes it's difficult to tell. And I have to say, Claudia, yours is the most complicated because it's a mix of white and red. So, when you said rosé, I actually think you got it the nearest. And Alan's, yours is a white wine with red food colouring because we thought you might cheat. But there was a Californian wine grower called Robert Hodgson, and he was upset by how inconsistently his wine fared in competitions, and he thought that maybe the experts don't really know what they're doing. So he did an experiment in which he served the same wines to the same experts at different times, and the findings, they were absolutely stunning as far as the wine industry was concerned. Only 10% of the judges were consistent in any given year, and none of those were consistently consistent. So if you made a good judgment one year, maybe you didn't make a good judgment the next year. And he found that in California, all the medals given out for wine were effectively distributed at random because really even the experts weren't sure. And it can even be difficult to tell red from white in a blindfold test.